here with Dave. Got Tom on my left. We're about to start this podcast. Is DJ Swaz dead? Who knows?
Who knows?
Where is Swaz?
Oh, shit.
Where is he?
Oh, shit.
And we're in.
Oh. Hello, hello.
Hello for episode 3 in the Voice Arena of the YuckyDuck Podcast.
Voice Arena, I forgot about that.
The yeah. Voice Arena.
I've motherfucking didn't. I need to turn myself down just a tiny bit. We're at episode 3. I'm happy we made it this far. I didn't think we would. I thought we'd be dead or something.
No, I thought we would.
You just got to keep going at it, haven't you?
Where is Rob Swain? Well, I'll tell you where Rob Swain is. It's fucking Bug Jam. That's where he is.
Oh, he's fucking hell. Oh, so festival.
Yeah, because we actually went on a festival, didn't we, Thomas? We went to Benicassim Festival in Spain, and now we are back with many stories to tell.
And Rob did the Glasgow a couple of weeks before as well.
And then New York slightly before that.
Yeah, New York slightly before that. Now he's doing Bug Jam. Bloody hell, he's on the...
I'll beat Tom. After the week we had, I'll be fucking dead doing a Bug Jam.
Oh yeah, yeah, I don't think I could do Bug
Jam.
One
festival screws me in.
I'm real chill what I've done.
Yeah.
I'm fine.
If I do longer than like a week.
Can you do festivals?
Can I?
I kind of realise that I can probably do about 2 days and that's about
it. Oh really?
Yeah.
No, if I go to a festival now, I like to do the whole early bird. Get there early.
I thought that, but then I went a bit strong on the Thursday night at Benicassim and then missed the second day.
Yeah, oh really?
So I got a little bit drunky pants.
Ooh. Sorry, I opened this.
I did request you open it beforehand, mate. You
I'm know. On the sugar free now because I'm trying to lose weight.
Oh, sugar free of weight.
Energy drink.
What? Little bitch lost 7 pounds.
7 pounds.
Yeah. 7 pounds. I swear that's a film, isn't it? Is it a film?
7 pounds in how long though? Because it won't be like a week.
Oh, 2 weeks.
2 weeks.
Yeah,
7 pounds in 2 weeks is still fucking good.
Yeah, it's all right.
Lose about when I really try about 2 pounds a week.
Yeah.
Well, are you using the that MyFitnessPal app or anything?
No, someone keeps telling me to do that to check my
your macros.
I can tell from what I'm eating. I'm eating way under my calories.
Oh,
and I'm burning off more than what I'm eating.
I started, I think I probably did, I don't know, like 1,200 a day for about 5 months.
I think that's what I'm on. Yeah, about 1,400 or something like that. Yeah. It goes up and down depending
that's
on training.
That's what you need to do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You just eat less, then...
Yeah. And what? Eat a small... I use like a bowl instead
science.
Of a plate.
Yeah.
It's simple science.
Yeah. It's just simple science.
It's simple science.
That's all it is, guys. It's simple science.
Stop, like Rob said last week, stop putting it in here. What's that fucking noise, Tom?
It was steam.
Steam.
Mate. Oh, you need to turn that shit
I've
down.
I've turned it down. I've
the game
someone
websites are available.
Yeah, but none of them are worth using.
Yeah,
someone
they're all shit.
Because tell them we're on live on a fucking podcast, bitch. Oh, shit. It's Jay Kizzle. Jay
you're
Kizzle. About fam.
You're straight up, man.
If you, this is obviously not live, but I want to go live with it, but kind of not at the same time.
What do you mean?
I don't know whether it's a good idea because we can go YouTube live.
What, you want to do this live?
No. Well, yeah, eventually, but I don't know how to do it.
Well, I think we have to get a bit more views for it.
Yeah.
That would be hard to
do. I honestly believe that the key to this is constant, good content.
Yeah, it's persistent, yeah.
It needs to be. Like, I think it needs to be
I
there
just
weekly
chill
at the same
it
time.
Out.
Dave wants to do like 4 in 1 week and then nothing for like. A week and then just as and when.
Nah, once a week's good. Like it gives us enough content, gives us time to not see each other.
Once a week.
Although it's going to be tough when we all want to go party.
Oh, we'll be fine.
Party where?
We'll party from
actually,
the money
we could
from
do like a
bitch.
Hungover podcast.
Oh, hungover podcast.
Or a drunk one where we could drink before
good.
We got, yeah.
Like, but obviously Tom would have to get drunk and probably the controls. It would just be us.
No, Tom
like,
can get drunk. You can control that shit when he's drunk.
Tom would just be put in trap music.
We get someone stand out with some string.
God, this great song.
We could get him on string. Softie, I thought this would be a great time, actually. I haven't told you about this.
Oh, God. What is it?
On holiday.
Yeah.
I got you a present.
Oh.
You told me to get some.
Oh, you didn't.
Yeah.
Oh, you little bitches. Thanks, man.
So basically what I've handed him to audio listeners are a deck of bicycle cards, which for...
And for anyone watching.
For anyone watching, which for magicians and card work, bicycle is the key deck.
Oh, dude.
Yeah, that was a Civil War. There was so many
Civil War.
There was so many fucking packets. And I was like, what would he like? And there's all laid out in front of me. I was just like, fuck it.
Oh,
honestly,
thank you, man.
Don't bother.
Thank you, dude. That's awesome. I'll,
But I thought it'd be good to give you live on the podcast.
I'll drop you some
No, don't worry about it. It's a present.
You sure?
That's not how gifts work.
Are they expensive? Well, I did say to him as well, I was like, get me something good, I'll give you some dollar bills. Because I saw you that you had a... Well, I don't know what your deck
bro's
was.
Bro's mind.
It looked awesome.
Oh, shit. I mean, we can't just keep pulling stuff out on an audio, but his bro's mind deck is really nice.
Oh, yeah, that is fucking...
Well, it got a bit awesome. Ruined in my fucking pocket when I was walking around.
Oh, man, look at the material. The nice. Colours of them. That is awesome, yeah. Anyway, yeah, sorry. No one can see this if they're listening.
But, yeah, anyway. I thought that one of the main themes of today's podcast...
Yeah?
Could be, Tom, you got it lined up?
Oh, I have.
Well, you know how everybody's... Well, what is the main thing going on today? Go on, Tom, hit it. Oh, shit.
Oh.
Oh, shit.
Oh.
Do you recognise it?
Yeah.
Oh, the remix.
It's a remix.
Oh, the remix.
Turn up a snare.
Oh, turn up a snare in my headphones.
We're getting our phones.
We're getting our phones. We're gonna.
Oh, it's the only time we're allowed to get our phones.
Why? I don't know whether to let this play through.
These fucking.
We need to get to the drop.
We do.
Softie needs to experience it.
How bad it is.
Oh no. Oh no.
I thought you guys said it was terrible.
Is that terrible? This is dope. Here we go. Oh.
It's actually awesome.
It's not bad.
Yeah, I listen to this.
I am all about this.
This is amazing.
So good.
Let that run in the back.
I need this playing in my headphones now when I play.
So Pokemon fucking Go has
Pokemon
been,
Go.
Has absolutely been
How is this
running.
Not going to come up?
It just wasn't. I think it might be
I almost didn't want to talk about it because everyone else is.
What level are you? Because you've just got...
What level? Game. I am a cease. I've only just started. Six. I'm a newbie to it. I downloaded it the day it came out. I just didn't fucking touch it. I just didn't have time.
Mate, it's about a very busy man for a couple of weeks. You can't just, it's not one of these games that you can just fucking pick up.
Yeah, well, I've got a little tactic now, so when because I miss out on all the walking, I only get to do it when I walk my dog. I've got a tactic now, I put it in my sat-nav little slot, my phone, and people say 20 miles per hour, that's fucking lies. That's a lie.
What, 20 miles an hour is the limit for...
Yeah, they say once you go over it, stops working. That's bullshit, because we were doing... Libby was driving me at like 50 miles per hour the other day, and I was catching Pokemon.
No, you really? can catch Pokemon
I'll
at,
catch
that,
Pokemon,
you can catch
yeah,
Pokemon
oh, yeah, yeah,
at
yeah.
that speed, but your eggs, your time, the thing on the egg, the speedometer on that, not speedometer, the distance thing on that won't count.
Oh, is it under 20, isn't it, for that?
Yes.
Oh, shit.
I thought it was 12
Yeah, it is. It's 20 kilometres. 12 miles.
Oh, mate, I might just get like a quad bike.
Mate, I got all I do is I've bought this
I
is how hardcore
I
this is how
walking.
Hardcore I've got into it, right? I bought like a little fucking arm strap that sits like
like running.
That sits on my bike and I was out there. I've been for the past 3 days, I reckon I've dropped like maybe two pounds or something.
Really?
Because I'm fucking just running around everywhere, just going out and trying to catch Pokemons. I'm sweating as we fucking speak in here. It's so hot.
It's fucking warm.
But you just see people out everywhere doing it.
Well, it's funny, yeah, because the first time I did it, I walked into the park and usually everyone's like, oh, hello, yeah, with the dogs, like everyone's all right. Like you always do like a bit of classic being British. Morning, hello. And no one was looking at me.
No one's looking at me.
I wasn't looking at anyone. Just look up and the heads are down. My heads were down. No one was talking. The dystopian world.
Is it good
the
though?
Future of the earth. Well, it's fucking weird.
But is it
it's
a good
weird
thing
no one was looking
thing?
At each other. No one was interacting. I mean, the game, you see get people do playing the game together, but no one's, you know, how's
it's a good
Sally?
Thing.
How's the Nan?
How's the
but fucking it, everyone, old people, young people,
but it cuts
middle-aged
off them
people.
Bullshit conversations. How's Sally and how's the Nan?
Yeah, but if you don't generally care about the Nan,
no one genuinely cares about.
No
that,
one cares about Nan.
No one cares about.
Till we
Nan.
Get her money.
I just want her money.
Die!
No one cares about the boy. Like, how is the weather? Oh, fucking hot today. I've already said it, but it fucking is boiling.
Oh, that's bad. I can see now. I keep looking through the map.
You had your eye covered up.
I know. I'm always like this. Like, you looking at my eye, boy? There we go.
Yeah, but I reckon it's a good thing, all in all. I genuinely do.
Yeah, I think it's a good thing. It's getting kids healthy.
You see all like the... Like today, you saw, no offence to it, like, but you see all like the goths who stay inside. You can tell like they don't go outside.
Yeah, yeah.
And Tom smelt one today.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh.
As I was catching a ride on.
Hey, man, I might teach them to clean. They might get... Someone said, oh, dude, but...
Well,
we're playing Pokemon,
I didn't
man.
Say, I didn't
you
say
want to hang out with my
British. So I was just like,
yeah.
Oh, no. Oh, I smelled it as it came past. And I was
yeah,
like,
he did
oh.
it passively. Like, oh, fucking hell, what is that?
It's like,
Jesus Christ. Fucking hell, something died, like.
I had that right.
Is that like, ooh.
I had that in Game Station because I try and avoid awkward situations at all costs. And when I used to work at Game Station years ago, I had that like what you're saying. Like,
well, you worked with a punger.
Pardon?
You worked with someone who smelled.
No. It was in the line, and I was serving someone, and the guy behind me, the guy behind him was a chav, and
yeah,
the
guy was
a smelly fucking, and the chav just went in on him. It was fucking hell. You ever heard of deodorant? And I was just dying inside.
I mean, we
all wanted to say it, but we fucking didn't.
Oh, I love people that like unconsciously fucking ruthless to
oh,
people.
Oh, and it's unconsciously as well. They'd never.
Oh fucking... yeah, they know, but they don't know. If you know what I mean? Like it's like a trigger.
Yeah.
Like they said, I'm like, oh fucking hell, mate, you stink.
You fucking stink. Jesus. You heard a fucking empty piss, right?
Fucking I'm not.
I'm dinger.
Yeah.
What? That's what they say.
Yeah, I'm dinging.
That's
mate.
What Londoners say.
Yeah,
anyway.
I'm dinging, mate.
You're fucking humdinging, mate.
You're absolutely humdinging.
But personally, I think is a better thing is a bad thing. But to the Pokemon guy. I am level 15.
What are you, Tom?
Is that it?
What colours are you?
Ooh. Team Valor.
This can divide the country.
I am red. Brexit.
You're red.
Red.
I have also chosen red.
Ooh. So we're all team red.
We are.
Anybody listening out there, if you're team red, go take those gyms. Team Valor. My girlfriend is actually the blue team, and I can't remember what team that is. Fucking whore.
I actually just chose red because my friend Doug's really good and he destroyed
that's
loads of,
why
he destroyed loads
chooses.
Of gyms and then he was like, yeah, look after these for me, so I do.
What, you don't look after gyms? You're well, level
I don't have
six,
to, but he commandeers them and then I fucking go in there and just keep an eye on it.
I won my first gym today.
Did you?
It was in there for my, what was it, my Nidoqueen was in there for a full 5 minutes.
Was it
to
break them down by like three levels or something like that?
No. Times. When you get a high level Pokemon, you can obviously take on gyms, and then once a person from the red team has taken that gym by battling other people's Pokemon, then anybody in the red team can then put their Pokemon in there.
Let's not do that.
Well, it's kind of absolute. It's normal. It's natural.
Oh, it's natural.
Yeah.
I might pull.
It's
natural. It's natural. Don't fight it, baby. I might pull the mic down to my arsehole when I fight.
If that happens, I'm leaving. I'm done.
Make sure that's always his mic as well.
Oh, mate. These things will smell by the end of like. Ooh. Give them a year if we've been using them. They're gonna stink of our breath.
Well,
we all got our own one.
Yeah.
Could we put a little label
on it? Actually, I don't know because they've been swapped around now.
Could we put a little label on them all?
All right, we'll put our names on it.
Just because it feels cuter if we all get our own mic. I like that.
Yeah. Oh, I wanted different colour ends on them. You can buy like different colours.
Oh, there we go.
Yeah, you can as well.
Oh, we'll be colour coded to our teams, but then we'll all be red.
That's true.
What team is Rob? Do we know? Is he red as well?
I am not sure.
I almost want to change mine to yellow. Yellow's a lot cooler than it.
I'm guessing you can't change. I'm guessing once you're in, you're in.
Do you think?
I think so.
Yeah, that kind of makes sense.
What about the future of Pokemon Go?
The future?
Because we're only in the first stages. And Tom, pull up some fucking info about what the fuck is... It took over like... in the first 2 days, it surpassed... I don't know. I'm going to butcher these. It's best for
Tom. Whoa. It's almost surpassed Twitter.
There you
on
go.
On the downloading.
You know, almost.
It might have now...
I thought it did. I thought it smashed it.
No, it's smashing Tinder.
So oh, yeah, explain yeah, how it's smashing Tinder.
But it's caught up with Twitter,
Tom.
Though, right? It's catching
explain
up with Twitter.
How it's smashing Tinder.
I'm trying to find it.
Because you can't walk down the street if fucking not seeing anyone. It's ridiculous. And I've talked to so many random people because of it. Whether it be, you know...
Those guys are making, like...
Nintendo
a
are out the fucking... Out of their... well, their divot or whatever they was in.
Yeah, yeah.
That's a great thing for me because I love fucking Nintendo. Look, Mario Kart Wii shit. I'm always constantly buying.
Yeah, I do love Nintendo. I mean, those guys
got my Zelda figurine
games.
Here. For audio listeners, you should really watch the video because I decorated the...
thing is, I do love Nintendo. I still play some stuff. My friend at work just got me into getting a 3DS again. But, I mean... You can see why they're dipping. There's so much more.
They don't keep up with... Yeah.
Everyone wants real and amazing.
What were you going to say, Tom?
It's funny you should say about them, sort of like their value in that, because they're actually worth more than Sony now. Fuck. They've just beaten Sony. As of today, Nintendo has reached 39.8 billion. Whereas Sony is at 38.34.
Stony. That's fucking hell. Insane.
That is
Nintendo have
so
doubled.
Many.
Nintendo have doubled in 15 days. It's totally unheard of.
That is incredible.
Well, they refused for a long time to go on mobile devices. Like they still don't really. Like if I was screaming for this, I was screaming for a Pokemon MMO like 10 years ago. Maybe about 6 years ago, screaming for like imagine if you had a World of Warcraft world where they one-upped it. They made it in the real fucking world.
Well, the thing is, that's because Nintendo actually listened to the fans. That's why, because everyone's been saying that.
Do they though?
Yeah, definitely. I think Nintendo listen. I think they're probably the only company because Xbox fucking don't. Sony don't
we
really,
work
but
in,
Sony
you
don't
work
really need
in this
to
kind of field.
But you know, all these kind of companies and like small labels and stuff like that. I say the small time game companies do, but I mean things like Nintendo. If they want something new, they always make it. If they're like, I want a new fucking
I
Zelda.
Guess so.
I want it to look like this, and the game always goes that way. They always listen to the
I
fans.
Think they stay true to their fans, definitely. Yeah. Like with the
and
Zelda
this
games.
Has been a long time coming. Do you remember that little Google
mate,
trailer?
Like
they did been a while
fuck,
ago?
Oh, mate. When I heard it was coming out, I knew it was going to be big, right? I knew it was going to be big, but I never knew it would take off like this. Like, literally, people getting hordes of people down the street. There's videos. You look like one video, Tom, of like a fucking thing being spotted. It's just insane. Have you seen these videos?
Yeah. There was almost like Charizard in like a. Somewhere in New York,
there's a Charizard
like
in New York.
Hundreds, and maybe even like 600 to 700 people there. It was insane.
What would you want to catch?
What do I want to get? I want
my Charizard all the time. Charizard.
Charizard.
It's got to be a Charizard. Charizard was always my favorite. But come on, what
Charizard. Good. Squirtle. Good.
Squirtle. No, we've got
sorry,
a Squirtle.
I'm sorry for those people out there. But Bulbasaur's a loser.
Do you think? I think Squirtle's more of a loser than Bulbasaur is. Fuck
what?
Water Pokemon.
Are you serious?
Fuck water
Squirtle
Pokemon.
Squirtle is way cooler than Bulbasaur. No one ever picked Bulbasaur.
Maybe Blastoise looks cooler than Venusaur. I'll
yeah,
give you
Blastoise
that.
Is Blastoise fucking looks sick. Dope. Yeah. That's
what's this
way
Tom, that we're putting up right now?
It's a stampede for a Vaporeon.
Yeah, New York City. I've seen this one. This is cool. Check this out. We're literally looking at people just getting out their car. Like, you can't
streams
even count.
Streams of people. Literal streams of people.
Fucking hell.
You can't even count.
People getting out of their cars. What about the people who just... His wife's pregnant. My wife's having a baby here. Let us through, like. Please.
Look, people are like saying, there's a Vaporeon. Oh, my God.
Absolutely ridiculous.
It's ridiculous, but I'm a 28-year-old man, and I'm going out of my way.
You're 28 now?
Yes.
Okay, yeah,
I'll be 29.
Are
oh, shit, am I 29?
I have no idea.
I'll be 29 in November.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm going out my way to run out the house every fucking half an hour, just going, you know what, I need to go get more Pokemon.
Yeah, I haven't got that hook on this yet.
Oh,
I love
have.
The idea, but I think for me...
Was Pokemon
I'm
always
real hooked on my FPSs at the moment. I have been for about a year now, so I can't get myself
Counter-Strike Go.
Yeah,
CS:GO, Overwatch, man,
Overwatch.
For me.
You know, I think this game would have got me around the Skyrim phase. You know, this would have really fucking hooked me then. You know, going out adventures, catching stuff, collecting
well,
stuff.
We're legit going
hoarding,
out
the hoarding phase that you get in gaming.
Well, we're legit going to Nottingham tomorrow.
Really?
Just for like Pokemon.
Just for Pokemon Go.
Oh, wow. God, you guys.
If you want to fucking join, you got work tomorrow.
Well, no, I've got work tomorrow.
I'm going to try to pull you in. Let us know, but we are leaving like quite early.
And, and the car is full, so he's led you into false promises.
Well, then
there.
You could just invite a load of other friends and you just join us.
Yeah, I'll just stay in and play Counter-Strike all day.
I've lived the Counter-Strike dream. I've done that.
Yeah.
I'm so over that now.
Yeah, I had a bit when I was younger. Then I get back into I'm really bad with phases of games.
What, like 1.6?
Well, or just, yeah.
Did you go back as far as 1.6?
No, not
or
as far as
1.6. Source?
Source, yeah.
Oh, scrub.
Yeah, 1.6
mate,
is
I,
shit.
I was
though.
I played 1.6 semi-professionally.
Well, 1.6 was where it all started.
You yeah,
didn't
but
play
you
1.
Don't
6, want to
play
you're
it now. You
scrub.
Could you could jump back to Source now. You can't jump back. To
yeah,
better could.
Well, yeah, you could, but you it's not like oh, hey kid, pick up this game. Look
yeah,
at
yeah,
it.
Yeah.
I better be rife with warhacks now.
Oh, 1.6 is yeah.
So they've just added this I can't remember what it's called. Prime matchmaking or something. So you have to have a mobile phone now, you know, authenticator to go with the
a bit like what Blizzard do.
Yeah, so okay. So you stop smurfing, Well, it's meant to stop smurfing, essentially, and stuff like that, and hacking. I don't know how it stops hacking, because people tend to use a different account when they hack and stuff like that. But we played the other day with someone without Prime matchmaking, and what it's left is just hackers. Like, you don't want to play outside of it now.
Wow, really? Is this Counter-Strike Source you're going to know?
You can watch, like, replays on, like, shitty death matches and just watch them follow you through the wall and stuff.
Yeah, it was getting really bad when we started finishing. I mean, I'm going to stand here.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to stand here and admit to you, I took the if you can't beat him, join him approach, and I did hack for a while.
Did you actually?
Yeah, for sure.
Well, actually, speaking about this, guess who's already trying to hack?
Can't even see.
Guess who's cheeksy doodling on Pokemon Go?
Someone reverse engineered the app, and there's a way you can
not
see
move.
Where the Pokemon are, like on your desktop computer.
Oh, I've heard that it's really easy.
And
to
then you just go and run to where it is.
Really easy to do it. It fucking took me 2 hours because I was doing DOS fucking shit.
But that's still easy though. It shouldn't be that.
No, I'm not.
It shouldn't be that fucking easy.
Right, Snowden.
It's I don't care how easy it is. It's cheating.
Yeah, it's
the
cheating.
The whole point
also.
Of Pokemon Go is to go out and explore and
I'll stand here and admit it's cheating.
I cannot believe you used to wall hack.
Well, yeah.
He wall hacked up until like 6 months ago.
Yeah, for sure.
He wall hacked on CSGO really badly.
I can't even believe
it. What?
I disowned you as a friend.
Fuck it. I got so annoyed at like fucking people just wall hacking. If you can't beat them, join them.
Some people are just very good and you can confuse it with wall hacking.
I got accused of hacking most games.
I've had it a couple of times.
Big dick.
Yeah, but
especially when I'm clutching with the AWP.
Tom was good, to be fair.
My clutching with the AWP is just people just get.
It's cheating. It must be cheating. I wouldn't wall hacking games unless like with my friends, unless they was like thinking, dude, they're cheating. Can you just fucking do
was
that?
Was you cheating that day when we played together?
No.
Fucking looked me in the eye.
I fucking looked you in the eye and told you I wasn't cheating
because we were in a party together.
Well, it depends what account I'm on. If you know I'm using my main account, I don't cheat because I want that clean. My Hermagerd account is clean. But I have around 5 or 6.
Hermagerd, is that the one I've
got? Hermagerd. That's my main Steam account.
Because I've got Hello You Cunt at the moment.
I feel like this is a confession booth for me today.
Yeah.
In the Yucky Duke podcast.
Cheatsy doodle.
I can't believe you cheat on a game.
Huh? Cheating on a game!
David.
I don't like to do it on every game.
Yeah, that's true, I suppose.
But it's Pokemon, because you can't fucking get ahead now. Everyone's ahead.
Yeah, well.
The thing is, but like, it's restricted to your desktop, so it is kind of hard, and it's kind of not worth doing because it is a long fuckabout. But what it is good for is scouting before you go out. So you kind of, I'm seeing patterns now around Lincoln because you have to put in the longitude and latitude, and it brings like a Google Maps of where Pokemon spawn. And I kind of know now like which Pokemon spawn in which area without kind of but it's so fucking random though. That's the thing.
Yeah, because I mean, there's algorithms on like really rare ones where, I mean, I hate to say it, some people will never find.
Don't say that to me because I want a Charizard so much.
Some people will not get them all.
No, but have you seen someone already has?
Somebody
the New York lad.
I thought it was except for certain ones. He's
got all that's currently available.
Available, that was it.
Which is like 142. The ones you can't get are like the legendary birds.
Yeah.
Mew and Mewtwo. Yeah.
Okay, so yeah, I was going to ask this actually. Why is it so random? Why is it 142? So it's just taken out the legendary birds.
The legendary birds, Mew and Mewtwo.
A part of me wants it to stay just the original 151, as in with the Mew and stuff like that. But another part of me says that would make the game so stale. You'd have to carry on. Yeah. But there's just so many shit Pokemon now. There's one that looks like a key ring.
Man, I work with a guy. Me and him kind of had this conversation time. He kind of likes it. Well, I think he likes it still. But man, it was only good when we had those first load of Pokemon. And I remember even that phase, I was still young enough to love it. And they added a load more. And for some reason, I just went, I'm not watching this
anymore. To be fair, I started giving up after like the second gen.
Yeah.
Like when they brought that out, I kind of tried to get into it. But I was like, I'm just not sticking with me.
Yeah.
But how would you keep a game like that fresh?
Well, I don't know. Maybe we could have turned out there's some secret way that you could evolve them three more times.
Look at this
or
thing.
What's
this thing called, Tom?
This is a Pokemon called Klefki.
Look at that. I mean, they sat around a table and they literally got. There was like, what are we going to do? We've done so many Pokemon.
How soon after our generation of Pokemon was that?
I don't know.
That honestly, is that a joke? Are you guys pranking?
No, that's not a joke. I caught one of these in the latest Pokemon. Like I played Pokemon, one of the latest ones, like about a year ago on a Nintendo DS, and I caught one of these and I laughed because that's how I found out.
It's almost like the design team was like sat in a room and like one guy was just spinning his key ring going, oh, what's the next one we can think of?
And some other guy was just pointing at him going, fuck.
No, you've got there.
Clef key,
let's go.
The worst thing about it is Pokemon never really made that much sense. I was okay with that. Now it really doesn't make any sense.
Oh, you can call anything a Pokemon,
though? Well, Pokemon's kind of an animal. You know, you're going out catching the animals, collecting Pokemon, seeing and... That ain't a fucking animal.
That's an object, sir. Like, what we're going to do, we're going to do mobile phones now. So what would you call the mobile phone Pokemon? Phony.
Phony?
Phony Mon.
Yeah.
Deck of cards. Trickster.
Dodecamon.
Dodecamon.
So it's got to be like a... fancy. What's a dodeca? Is that 10 sides? 10 sided cards.
Tom, do me a favor. Like, just on your own, just pull up all the fucking Pokemon. Like, every single one. Like, the gens, right? And then go to the very latest one. Because I'm thinking, the more they get through all the generations of Pokemon, right, the more ridiculous it gets. So I would like to see the very latest Pokemon design that was ever... Well, it's done. Well, to be fair, do you know what they did, actually?
What?
In the new Pokemons, like the ones that came out last year, I want to say it was X and Y, Tom. I don't know. I think I got Pokemon X or something with the Nintendo DS. I might be, could be wrong, but it never stuck with me. But do you know what they did? They did Mega Evolutions of, like, Pokemon. Only very few. So, like, you could get a Mega Charizard. So you got Charmander, Charmeleon, Charizard. Then you could go Mega. Upgrade.
Mega this Charizard. Is what I meant when they could have done the next series.
That was dope. That was cool.
They could have done like a three, because that's what that Mega Charizard sounds fucking
Mega
awesome.
Charizard looks amazing, if you can also pull that up, Tom. Mega Charizard, it looks amazing. Mega Blastoise looks amazing. But they didn't do it for all the Pokemon. They only did it for the main ones.
Yeah. Because the thing is, though, when you get hooked and enjoy stuff like that, you only want better. Everyone always wants better.
Do you think?
Yeah. I think if you get something new, it's shitter, then you have to get better. No one wants to downgrade
with all
the... That's
a great point. I've
never thought that. No one wants to downgrade and from the base games again. We'll forget about the old ones that we all love. Why?
But then when does it get ridiculous? So if we
better.
If we kept going to that point...
Well, I mean, you've seen that key Pokemon. I mean, is 10 more evolves of Charizard worse or a Pokemon that looks like a fucking set of keys?
I agree with you. I totally agree. So what's this?
This is the latest load.
Well, I was trying to find Gen 7 because apparently that's the most recent gen, but I can only find Gen 6, but... These themselves still look.
Oh, what? I see. No. They're not bad. Like Chespi and Quadra, they're all right because I remember getting into these. That's second gen, isn't it, Tom? These are all second gen.
No, this is Gen 6.
Are you joking?
This is XY, apparently, yeah.
Oh, of course, yeah. Because
these kind of look like. They've done exactly what we were just saying. It looks like they've just mega
just
evolved
not,
Pikachu.
Is this just chunky Pikachu?
Yeah, mega evolved Pikachu.
Yeah, but it doesn't even look.
They look more Japanese now. Which
that,
is kind of
to
cool.
Be fair, Pancham and Pangoro, Tom,
oh
they're
my.
Your fucking Pokemon.
Oh,
right
my.
So we're just looking at Pokemon that looks like a anybody who isn't into Pokemon. Looks
I
like
didn't
a
think the original Pokemon looked super Japanese, which is kind of a shame, really. So I think he's kind of cool.
What is
a Genghis Khan?
A Mewtwo
that,
Y and X.
Where's a Mega Charizard, Tom? There it is. Look at Mega Charizard. Look at the Mega Charizard. And they did different versions. Look, Mega Charizard Y to X. So Charizard Y was still the same color, but X was like black.
Wow.
See, that's
where they should have gone. That's what they should have done earlier.
Yeah, look, Mewtwo X and Y, look. And then Lucario was a decent Pokemon. And he's great in... oh, my God. Why can't I think of what that fucking game is on Nintendo? Smash Bros.
Yeah.
Lucario's
I don't
great
like that
character.
Little Leo or Lit Leo. That looks shit.
Look at Horlucia. He just looks like a guy in like a pigeon costume.
Is that
Horlucia?
This guy a fucking carnival.
Yeah, I agree with you though. I think they should have kept it going as in the normal evolutions.
Yeah, that'd be cool if they'd done
that. That would have been really cool. Yeah, they should have done that.
Yeah, because it was better. Imagine not having your Charizard and you're like going for a pack and it's like an even better one, like Mega Charizard. Like imagine guaranteed getting that in your cards. Fuck
the
me.
Cards, though.
I bet they've
the
gone
cards?
Through the roof.
A Charizard on eBay, if you was to get an edition one, goes for around 500 or 600 quid.
I might have one in my
first edition.
Somewhere.
If it's first edition,
I don't
it's
know
got to have
first.
Like a little stamp.
Well, I definitely started collecting in the first. So I don't know whether it is. I don't know how quickly.
If you have, you might be sitting on a little bit of a mine there.
Yeah, I'll have to look into that.
There's a Charizard here on eBay for 1,500. Mint, first edition, shadowless Charizard.
What do you mean by shadowless? So it's like the print?
I have no idea.
Shadowless. What is the value of cards now, though?
I think the flat ones that weren't shiny were like kind of shadowed backgrounds, were they? Is that right? I remember them being like really washed out and they kind of try to put a depth in them.
What is it with Charizard? Because you don't get that for a Blastoise, I don't think, Tom. Like a first edition Blastoise goes for like 20 quid or some shit.
Is the hype around Charizard because that's what
everyone
Ash
wanted.
Ketchum had? Did he not have a Charizard that like disobeyed him for ages and then like in the final battle it finally started listening to him and it was dope? Yeah. Is that where all the hype for Charizard came from?
It looks dope, though. It's just a dragon.
It's like a dragon, and that's why it looks cool. And also, the card was pretty fucking powerful.
Yeah, it was, actually. I didn't even think about that.
Yeah, you could just dominate
To be
everyone.
Fair, right? I collected the cards, never played a game of Pokemon once.
Yeah, but that's kind of like what you're doing with this game, isn't it? It's the collection more than the fighting. Mm. Yeah, I think true. People like the battling, but it isn't. Fun.
I've heard you can't get particular type of Pokemon in different countries.
On Pokemon Go, I saw something on the subreddit that you can only get certain Pokemon in like different states as well.
Oh really?
So how did the guy how did that guy who got them all? Did he have to visit other states?
Yeah, he probably just visited the other states.
Oh,
and, but he also did all of it while working a 50-hour week.
Figure that out. What?
Somebody's cheating.
Do you think? That's what I said. I said, is he cheating or is he putting a lot of money into the game?
Yeah, he's put a lot of money in.
Yeah, but where would you put in money in what? So you can't buy a Pokemon.
You can't, but you can double XP.
You're working 10 hours a day. You haven't got that much fun.
Unless he worked near, like, Poker.
Well, no, he worked in New York. So I'm guessing in New York, there's Pokestops aplenty.
Yeah, that's true.
Thank God I had data out in Spain because I had three, by the way, if anyone's listening. Free data doesn't charge any more to your bill out in Europe while we're still in the EU, I guess. Free fucking data. I got there and I was there's no extra charge.
Who are you with?
Three.
I got a text when I come back just today saying I saved nearly 50 quid. I saved nearly 50 quid and I was out like...
I don't know what I've got. I assume I'll probably get paid charged.
Because who are you on?
Vodafone.
No, I'm with EE and they charged me 20 quid for 600 meg. But I still didn't use it all. I use my phone.
Even when you're playing Pokemon Go?
Even when Pokemon Go uses very little data. I was reading the other day that like 3 minutes of play is like 100 kilobytes.
Also, the maps run off Google Maps, which I do believe is free. It doesn't use your data when you use like sat-nav and Google Maps.
I guess it's just pinging information. That's all it is.
Yeah, it's literally just the map. It's just the location thing.
And then the overlay. So I assume they didn't use the location. Yeah.
I find it real surprising that we don't pay for like a GPS. To say that's free is pretty fucking dope.
Yeah, but we do pay for it. We do pay
in
for
what
data.
Way?
Data.
No. GPS and data
you mean
are
for
two
like...
different things. I mean for like knowing where you are, like because GPS signal.
Yeah, but on your phone to get your location, you have to turn on your mobile data. That's you paying for it.
Your mobile data.
I guess so. Yeah.
Yeah, I suppose, yeah, but I
well,
don't...
What did you mean?
No, yeah, I think...
I thought it was like a separate thing. I thought, like, GPS was a separate, like,
entity. You are right. What you're saying is... Yeah, and Tom's also right, yeah. So when you turn it on, obviously you've got to have a phone and pay a monthly bill to be able to turn it on, but it won't affect your monthly... So you've got a gig of internet a month.
Yeah.
It won't affect that, but you do have to pay... You can just take a SIM card out and have a sat-nav.
Really?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's...
I'm pretty sure you can do that.
You can't, because I turn off...
Turn off my mobile data now.
Yeah, get maps up, turn off your mobile data.
Right, okay. Are we doing this live?
Yeah, let's do it. Okay, so I go onto maps. Where the bloody hell Google Maps is? There.
This is intense stuff.
Here we go. This is intense shit.
Drum roll.
Yep, straight away. It knows that I am at Bishop Grove... Yarborough Crescent's there.
But how are you getting the information? Like, as in, how are you getting the...
I don't know.
See, yeah, the GPS works even though you take... Yeah, I totally agree with Softie there. It does. But I think we're both right in different senses.
Well, bugger me.
Yeah. I don't know why. I think the reason, right, I think the idea is, do you remember the old days of TomTom? You did have to buy a SIM card for that sucker.
Really?
Yeah, real old. I mean, like, when I was, like, 7 or 8, you had to have, like, a little, well, not like a data plan, but you did have to pay a monthly fee to TomTom for the little, basically, location thing in the back.
Really?
Like, little thing. They got rid of that, and it became free. Then we were getting, you can have Google on your phone or whatever on your phone, and then you'd be charged. People go, oh, fuck that, I'll just get the TomTom app.
TomTom app, though, was like 80 quid.
The smart idea was to go, well, let's make it free on here. Because all you do is pay for the TomTom and it's free forever. Mm. So now it just cuts out the TomTom. I suppose those guys have gone under big
time. Do you reckon TomTom's gone fucking under since the...
Well, you still see it, like...
You do, like...
The granddads are still running it, aren't they?
I mean, who doesn't use their phone and get out Google Maps now? Google Maps is the thing.
I think...
It's even better than Apple Maps,
50 plus are still keeping them alive. They'll die soon. Unless they got their finger...
They'll die off.
Yeah. Yeah, they'll die.
But fucking, like, I'm quite surprised Pokemon Go doesn't take that much data. That's really good. I like that.
Yeah, well, it has to not take a load of data because it will annoy far too
many
people.
All it does is rape your battery life.
Oh God, yeah.
Oh my Lord.
Yeah, it doesn't anything on new phones now.
I guess so.
But nothing to the extent of this. To the extent that me and Dave went out this morning around 11:30, 12-ish. And probably by 3-ish, 4-ish, we were coming back here to recharge with like 30% left.
We are totally legit buying battery backs.
Yeah, that's pretty brutal.
We are buying battery backs.
Well, you got these awesome cases now. My friend Phil,
the movie
goes
cases.
On tour lot, and he's got this cool little... yeah, you just put it on, keeps your phone protected.
What am I going for, Tom? Am I going for a movie case, or am I going to get one of these battery things? Because I'm thinking...
A movie case, the biggest movie case is 150% battery. So it will give you a charge and a half.
Okay, cool.
The power packs you buy will give you 6 whole new chargers.
I'm down with the power pack. But I said this to Tom, I'm buying a legit bum bag. Like one of those big things. I don't, because Tom was like, why don't you get a rucksack? And I was like, no, I don't want a rucksack. I'm going to get a big, thick bum bag.
You should get one of those bags that goes over your shoulder, like what all the dealers wear.
Yeah.
Like the Spanish.
No, oh, man. Not. Yeah, yeah.
Like it says Adidas like on this, it.
Like.
Like a man like
selling mankies.
Hat on the front of Ben, like a real fucking Ben.
I'm not getting one of those. What would look gay though? One of those bags or a bum bag? I think I'd look manlier with a bum bag. Tom, pull me up some fucking manly bum bags.
Manly bum bag.
Is there such a thing?
I don't think there is such a thing.
As a manly bum bag?
I don't.
No, Joe Rogan fucking has them.
I think girls rock bum bags better than dudes do.
I'm going to bring it in. Like, I don't think we should be afraid to wear bum bags. I'm going to fucking bring that back.
Yeah, I just don't get it, man. Put your shit in your pockets.
Yeah, but they fall out if you haven't got zips. Oh, hello. Here we go. I always love when Tom pulls something up slowly. Then he
I never
has to
carry
change.
Enough. If I'm going somewhere where I need a bum bag, I just take a rucksack.
There we go. Pokemon hunting with this bum bag. For anybody listening, it looks like just something you get out of Waterworld.
It's kind of like a...
Kevin Costner would
like the pocket on a kilt.
I bet it smells like whiskey.
Yeah, that is kind of cool, actually. I'd probably wear that.
I'd wear that. That's
I'd kind of, yeah, soak it in whiskey as
it's
well.
It's not a man purse. It's a satchel. Indiana Jones wears one.
Or just get that.
The man sack. We're looking at a fucking... basically a bollock sack. It looks like two bollocks.
Yeah, what are you
banter. Get it for the lads. We'll all have a man sack.
The man sack.
That black one, though, Tom, looks dope. That black one.
This one?
No. Down to the right. That one. See, that's got, like, multiple. Oh,
yeah, God, I kind of like that. It's like a tactical bag. I like that.
Tactical bag.
Yeah, that's kind of cool. That looks like I should have like fucking black rope around my shoulder and like a balaclava on. I like
that. I'm fine, sorry.
Just fucking melee kids out the way.
Essentially going out on the rob. Yeah. Pretty much.
Oh my God, a charge.
Speaking.
Go to sleep.
Go to sleep. Speaking of fucking Pokemon Go and children, a child, was it a child? No, a young girl found a dead potty whilst looking for a Squirtle.
I read this.
Have you seen this?
Yeah, she's looking for a water Pokemon.
That was it. It was American girl saying, I was looking for a water Pokemon, I found a dead body.
Yeah. But it hasn't put me off playing the game.
Please tell me she didn't say that.
She said it hasn't put her off.
Did she say that?
Yeah.
Come on.
Crazy ass bitch.
Why would that so
insensitive?
Someone
pulled the article up the other day, yeah.
What the fuck?
It hasn't put me off playing the game.
It wouldn't put me off. It
I don't think it'd put me off. Depends how waterlogged it was.
there's
like
already
the
been
film
deaths.
You get on a yogurt.
What Pokemon do you think that dead woman was? What combat points do you think she was?
Jinx. She looks she looks real bad.
You haven't.
We're gonna end it.
Sorry, Tom. Jinx, she looked real bad.
I don't know what the Japanese were thinking when they made Jinx.
Jinx is a weird Pokemon, but, to be fair. They went like left with that one, didn't they?
She's obviously a white woman who's blacked up.
Yeah.
So it's real mess.
It's a bit like
real
it's a bit gollywog-esque, isn't
it's
it?
Like a minstrel.
It is. It's straight up racist.
It is fully racist.
I never thought that until right now. Oh my god.
Yeah, they went a bit weird with that one. But then it is the Japanese and they have vending machines for piss soaked pants. Yeah. So
I've often told Leanne to just piss in pants and sell them on.
There's subreddits,
isn't it? Oh my god.
Softie just pulled up his phone looking at Jinxes right now.
God, it's kind of
I want to see some shit Jinx cosplays.
I think Jinx alone is just a shit Jinx cosplayer.
To be fair, is it even a
legit
Pokemon?
They've made it more purple nowadays. Is that for a reason?
Yeah, it's because they got afraid of being arrested for being racist.
They genuinely have purpled her up, but it's before she was
really?
More black.
Yeah, she was dark.
Oh, wow.
There's been deaths already due to Pokemon Go.
Really?
Oh, yeah. There's been deaths. Apparently...
Well, you're going to get that with such a popular game like of this.
Oh, no. The reason for this is incredible. I mean, apologies to the person who died. This guy died after being shot with his 70-year-old cousin when they broke into a home in Guatemala in an attempt to catch a Pokemon that was inside.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Oh, this is some Darwin Award shit, isn't it? These are going to get better and better.
But is that a lie? Were they just robbing the place?
Yeah.
You don't need to go into the house. It's not that specific.
Well, at the end of the day, breaking in, isn't it?
It's not that specific.
They still broke in.
Well, I'm not being funny. There's a golf club that's 10 minutes away from my house that keeps it, because you know I know where the Pokemon are. Yeah. I know where the fucking Pokemon are.
You're
mate.
My guy. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm your guy. You want to know where the Pokemon are? Yeah, I'm your guy.
Yeah, do me a bag of Jigglypuff, mate. Yeah, do me a bag of them, yeah.
No, I've got a bag of fucking Jinxes, mate.
Oh, mate, how many Jinxes you got down there?
17.
About £2 a pop, mate.
£2 a pop, mate.
£2 a pop, like, yeah.
But legit, mate. There is 10 minutes down the road. A golf club which just keeps spawning like loads of Pokemon.
And how do you know this, Dave?
Because
Because he cheated.
Because you're a cheat.
Cheatsy doodler.
I've used that cheat to get like 3 Pokemon.
I say you delete them. I say you delete those Pokemon.
You can't delete
right
the Pokemon.
You can
transfer
delete that,
it, mate.
You delete the app.
I'm not transferring.
And you
transfer
just start from fresh. And you come down
absolutely
to the bottom
not.
With me and grind like the peasants we had to be.
No. I'm
peasant
good.
Right here.
Absolutely good. But I'm thinking, can we go on this golf course? Do golf courses just let you on? Can we walk on a golf course?
I don't know.
How much would it be?
Hang
to
on
just
you
get...
mean the car home road one?
No,
I've got it.
Canic.
I've got it. Canic. I've got it. I've got it. Listen to me. What we're going to do is we're going to find out how much it is to play golf and not play golf. Just hire a buggy and go around Pokemon catching. Boom!
That is a good idea. That's really loud.
Well, I'm not paying to do that.
Please.
No.
You might as well just play
Please.
Golf.
Just go play golf.
And not catch Pokemon. That's going to get in the way of Pokemon catching.
You play golf. You'd really like it.
I don't like
Dave
golf.
Would not like it. Really it not. Requires
fuck
patience.
Golf.
Yeah.
I've got a lot of patience.
No, you haven't.
Yeah, I have.
No, you haven't.
I've learned how to hack in like 2 days.
Learned how to hack?
Was it a step-by-step guide?
You followed a step-by-step
files
guide.
Into other files.
He opened a RAR file and now he's a hacker.
Fucking Snowden.
He unzipped a fucking RAR file. Mr. Robot.
I'll have you know. How
ooh,
to...
have you guys watched Mr. Robot?
No, well, I've been told it's very good.
I want to. I'm just pulling this up. This is essentially how Dave is right now.
Oh, is this hacker.net?
Yeah, this is Dave Vaughan.
Is that a website?
I'm hacking. Look at me hacking.
Is that a website?
Yeah.
I'm literally just smashing my hands down on the keyboard.
I'm going to sit there. I'm going to sit there at my screen at work.
We're breaking into the Chinese government right now. Into the network. Into the network, guys. Mom, get out my freaking room! I'm hacking! I'm hacking into the Chinese network right now! I'm buying all the stocks!
I'm DDoSing the system!
I'm DDoSing the system! China's gonna crash!
Jesus Christ.
No, I don't want fucking turkey dinosaurs! That's the third time this week!
But yeah, that is hacker.net.
I'm going to sit there at work doing that and shit everybody up.
Oh yeah, we always
until somebody goes, Dave, that's hacker.net. What are you doing?
Sat there sweating, chewing gum with Red Bulls, like pretending you're in.
I'm in, guys. I'm into the white mop. What is it? The mainframe. Or
the mainframe.
I'm in the mainframe, guys.
Oh, straight up in the mainframe, bruv.
Area 61 was real.
But what I'm saying, the
61.
If I have to sell it to you, even though you already want to watch it,
I've seen four episodes.
Ah, well, then you probably already know that. You ever watch hacking stuff in films before? Or anyone who knows a bit about code and stuff like. It's always cheesy with like polygons twisting and like
going into the network. Yeah. The network hackers in the world, anonymous.
It's always like weird stuff, isn't it? It's not.
It's always like overlaid shit fucking videos on a screen.
Well, let's just say with the writers of these guys, they've clearly got some IT know-it-alls to sit down with them. And they've. I mean, I don't know much, but what I do know is when I watch it, I recognize things and get.
And you think,
yeah. They are using real shit, yeah.
Mr. Robot, I've heard people talk about it at work, actually, saying it's really good.
Yeah, it's very, very, very good.
Speaking of the really awful hacking scenes in a TV program.
Oh, God, no.
Can we just please watch this?
No. Oh, is this the bunny
one? Oh, yeah, this is good.
A port scheme?
No, this is major.
She's being hacked.
There's always adverts jumping up.
We'll isolate the node and dump them on the other side of the router.
Is this the one where two of them do it at once? Yeah, there we go.
Two people, one keyboard.
.com.
How are they doing it? Like, oh, can I just borrow the X quickly?
But that's how you stop a hacker.
What is that, video game?
No, Tony, we're getting hacked.
This guy comes along with his cheese sandwich, his ham sandwich.
There's only one way to stop a hacker, boys. It's coming right up.
Oh, yeah.
Where'd it go, Abby?
I didn't do anything. I thought you did.
We're not going to get pulled from YouTube for this, are we?
I did.
Hack over, guys.
Pulls out the plug.
Get Ethan it right out of fucking back.
Have you seen South Park?
You know, that looked like a HDMI to me, so I'm not going to complain. Movie mistakes.
Well, it's just ignoring it, isn't it? That's essentially what it is. If you put out the HDMI...
Well, they've kind of made the word hacker really cheesy now. I hate hearing that word, and all I think is like polygons and... Yeah, that weird thing they did in James Bond. It's like a nice little.
Remember Boris in James Bond? He was cool.
Boris.
Yeah, with a pen.
The bullet dodger.
He was in GoldenEye, I think.
Boris.
Come on.
What's his scream?
I'm invincible.
Yeah.
Because it's a certain click of the pen, and he keeps flicking it around.
Yeah.
He was my favourite Bond character, I have to admit.
Really?
Yeah. I don't know
what,
why.
Excluding Bond or including Bond?
Excluding Bond, because who was your favourite Bond actually?
Craig.
Pierce Brosnan.
Yeah. I
really like Craig.
Craig's a close second.
I was always
brought
up with Sean Connery. I love the guy.
Sean Connery's cool.
Sean Connery's best James Bond ever. But I have to agree, out of the modern ones, Craig fucking whoops ass.
He's like the perfect level of like gritty and gentleman.
Yeah.
Whereas that's why I don't like the fact that they're going to bring in Tom Hiddleston. He's favourite at the moment.
Oh, yeah.
Loki from Avengers.
Ooh,
but
no.
Too much of a gentleman. You know who it needs to be?
It's too much of a pretty boy like Pierce Brosnan was.
Idris Elba.
Yes.
Idris Elba.
Awesome.
He'll be a great one.
And if you don't want him, you're racist.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah, you're a fucking racist.
You're a dirty racist.
Plus, he's from London.
He's perfect. He's
a bit gritty.
Proper grime.
He's kind of like Daniel Craig, you know, like he's good looking, but he's like solid. His head's solid, like smack it, it's hard. Yeah. Whereas like Pierce Brosnan, it looks like brush a flannel on him.
I like Pierce.
Oh, I've got to rush.
I like
now.
Pierce Brosnan. Don't start slagging off Pierce Brosnan.
No, they're all too fucking
Pierce Brosnan.
Soft.
Oh,
I think Daniel Craig was the best one though. I'll give it. I've been swayed tonight. He is the best, Daniel Craig.
But yeah. I reckon Idris Elba will be that type of Bond that when he gets in a fight, he like stands there with his arms behind his back, waits to be hit by the enemy, and he's like, right, now I'm fired up.
That's the kind of Bond I want to see.
I want to see that.
Yeah,
I don't want to see Tom Hiddleston just looking like a thin weirdo.
I was going to say he's too thin.
Loads of cheesy shots of him like pulling out the camera, pan out,
texting Taylor Swift while he's on mission.
That was good.
Is he going out, Taylor Swift?
He's with Swiftie at the moment.
See, Tom Hiddleston, I loved him in Avengers. He was my favourite Avengers character. I love Loki. My friend did.
He's the best.
I fucking love Loki as a character. It's amazing.
Do you like any of his other films?
Never seen him.
Did you watch?
Oh shit! He hasn't really.
He probably has been loads of films.
Did you watch The Night Manager? the BBC series with him in. It's absolutely incredible.
Really?
Absolutely.
The Night Manager.
The Night Manager.
Sell it to me. What's it about?
It's just this guy who is working as a hotel concierge kind of guy. In, I think it's in Egypt during some big resistance rebel reform thing.
Ooh, now I'm sorry.
And some woman that he gets kind of interested in gets brutally murdered by the head honcho of one of these people who are supplying the rebels with all this stuff. And it's just like this cool guy. And then it becomes his mission to bring him down. So he like gets himself on the inside with this big baddie who's played by Hugh Laurie.
Oh, nice.
And is like British and awful and ruthless and perfect. And
I don't know who Hugh Laurie is.
House.
Ah, okay, cool.
Or Blackadder.
Blackadder, yeah.
I'm really shit with names.
Or Stuart Little's dad.
Stuart Little's dad.
I know him, House. So he's the main guy in House, right?
Yeah. And he plays like the major baddie. But the entire series is absolutely incredible.
I'm gonna have to watch that though. I do like the sound
it's
of that.
So good. I've just started watching I'm just halfway through Power.
I've just
Netflix.
Started House of Cards because everyone keeps raving about it.
Oh, House of Cards,
man.
Oh, I'm a big fan.
That first season.
Where are you up to?
I am up to where the girl, you know, so she's
The Beauty Spoilers. Girl.
You know the girl who works for the newspaper?
Yeah.
She always gets pushed to the bottom.
Yeah.
She got given the story by him, the secret, all shredded up, and then she gives it the story, tells the story. Episode after that. What happened after that?
Cool things.
What happened to the episode after that?
I don't know.
I've never watched it in my life.
I watched it the second episode. Third episode. No, fourth episode I'm on now.
I've just started watching Fargo, and that's dope.
That is awesome. That is also very good.
I've not watched that.
You seen the film?
No, not yet.
Is it related to the film?
Yeah, it's the same story, but they've done it differently. So, kind of. Still be some
true
spoilers
story,
in there. Yeah, I think now that you've got the option, watch the series first. Then watch
okay, cool.
Because of House of Cards, I now have to watch every Netflix series and that I watch with subtitles. I found watching House of Cards with subtitles a lot easier to follow because it is quite intense.
Dialogue.
The dialogue is very like American presidency.
Yeah.
To be fair, watching anything it's with dialogue,
tough.
Yeah.
I love the way he looks at the camera sometimes. And he
the way he just stops and then turns around. That first scene with the dog.
Cool. Yeah, man. It's just so cool.
Intense.
Yeah.
It's ruthless and intense.
That has brought back the information TV.
Yeah.
If you know what I mean. Not all the glorious Game of, not so my hate on Game of Thrones, my favourite TV show ever, but yeah, it's kind of brought back that dialogue and that depth.
I love it.
You're a bit of a movie fan though, aren't you? You're
one quite scene, you know. They could just pop in and pop out of the scene.
You're quite a movie buff though, Softie, aren't you?
Yeah, I do love my films, yeah.
Oh yeah.
We all do though,
I'm big filmy.
I know it changes all the time, but like what is your favourite film ever? I know it is hard.
I know my top three off by heart.
I know Tom's top three off by
heart. I don't know my top three. Mind you.
Yeah, I get that. I totally get it. It's very hard. I know like my classics is like fucking hell.
Like Shawshank. Shawshank. Like Green Mile. I think, what's that one? Whenever it comes on TV,
Shawshank
this is
Redemption.
Yeah, everyone's always seen.
This is England. Oh my God, it's the best.
That's not the best. No.
No, on Facebook, whenever it's on TV, everyone is like, oh my God, best movie ever.
That's
it's not.
England.
Shawshank, though, is like dope. Shawshank, I fucking love.
I like Shawshank.
Yeah, Shawshank is a very good film, but I don't think it's one of the best.
I've never seen Godfather.
No, I don't think I have either.
I've got
people
first
rave about that
on DVD. I think if you guys want to borrow it.
And then
I've got the first DVD.
Then people say DVD. What?
What's a DVD?
What's a VD player?
Yeah, well, it's a Blu-ray DVD. If that makes any difference,
but nah, you just download it.
Well, to be fair, actually, I do buy
allegedly.
I do buy my favourite films of the year on Blu-ray. As like it's like a habit.
Do you like do you like the collection of it, right?
The other year.
Do you like the feeling that you have a collection of it, a physical copy?
Yeah, well, to be fair,
I get it.
A digital
copy
of and Blu-ray, really no difference. So it's nice to have like a little stack of your favourite.
Yeah, because you can physically see it in your house. I get that. I totally get that.
Yeah, and I'm putting money towards, I kind of feel better that I'm putting.
I get that.
Because I do love films, so I like to put a bit of money, you know. If it's a good film. I mean, there are good films like, I wouldn't buy Shawshank, but then I would put money into Interstellar.
Mm. Do you like Interstellar? I fucking loved it.
Yeah,
loved it.
That was, I really disliked it. Beautiful film.
I loved it up until
the
end.
Don't even hang in.
Yeah,
high five.
That's awful.
Please.
Matthew Mahogany.
Yeah, I really disliked it up until that point. Literally that point, I loved the movie, and then it just went weird.
Yeah,
and I was
how else would you explain the Tesseract? How else would you? You could just can't put it into words.
Maybe I wanted something different than the movie.
I do have to agree with Tom on the fact that the ending was not how I thought they should have done it.
No.
They could have done it a lot, lot better. I think, because he wanted to keep fantasy and science side by side. So they did. They went all fucking hardcore on the physics, which was absolutely amazing. But he wanted to keep a bit of traditional writing and love and fantasy with it. But I think
didn't like that.
Her pull towards her boyfriend on another planet was enough. That was enough. That was a nice little, okay, we're still humans on this thing.
Yeah, yeah.
Whereas when they went that year, wasn't really human for me.
I get what you're
Inception
saying.
Was smart enough because it was an idea.
Inception's really good.
That could go wild because it's something we don't know about. But the bookshelf thing.
I didn't like the bookshelf thing. But the thing that I enjoyed most about Interstellar was the whole time thing. The way they dealt with time and going down to these planets. Like that's a thing that's never occurred to me that these planets.
And that's a legit thing as well.
It is a legit thing, and it's all true. It just never occurred to me that happened. That they have this entire different time system to you, and time up there is different to time down there. And
every minute they spent on this planet was about 30 days or something like that.
I can't remember.
It was something big because when it for like 40 years that guy was set up.
And
there
was only down there for like half an hour or some shit. And he come back and he was
old. I can tell you another really cool thing that I learned once that someone told me. I mean, I don't know the exact points of it, someone will probably fucking correct me. But if you had a train that went all the way around the Earth, and
I'm trying to visualize this.
Okay, a train track that goes all the way around the Earth, and it travels, it builds up to the speed of light, and it can travel at the speed of light.
Mm-hmm.
1 week on this train, for the people on board the train, anyone outside, I think it's like 200 years would go by, because the speed of light slows you down on the train just enough to keep you relative with the other time.
Speaking of trains...
Let me figure that out.
I can't remember the exact words on it.
We'll figure that out.
Have you seen Snowpiercer?
I really want to see that film.
I've not seen
that. Have you heard
about it? That's an underrated film, apparently.
Is that the train?
That's the train that's got that... It's got one of those engines that never stops. I don't know what the word is. What's the word? It's got a fancy engine on it.
What
do you mean? You just can't turn it off, or...?
Snow...
A rotary engine?
No, Snowpiercer...
Fancy engine.
Train.
A fancy engine. It runs on dreams.
I would have watched it, but...
Perpetual motion.
Oh, perpetual motion.
Perpetual motion engine.
So it just can't stop.
Yeah, what essentially the premise of Snowpiercer is that they pumped a load of chemicals up into the atmosphere to try and cool down the ozone layer or whatever it is. Something went terribly awry and it ended up causing a massive ice age across the entire world. And the only people that survived were the people that were on this train... That's got a perpetual motion engine, so it's constantly going. Yeah. They're fine. And on that train developed an entire, society. So the society was dictated by your ticket. If you were just one of the lowlifes who snuck on or whatever, you stayed at the back of the train. If you're one of the first class people, you're at the front of the train, and it's just how they survived and have survived for like 18 years or something.
I suppose the idea is kind of cool because it's like actual society, isn't it?
It's so cool.
And your ticket, I suppose, is your birthday. Yeah. You're being born.
That's you.
That's your ticket on the earth. You know, you're born in poverty or where you were.
And that's where you start.
Vagina. Yeah.
I do remember watching the train and it didn't look nice.
That's the thing. I've been told it's a very like underrated film.
Yeah.
Everyone says just watch it.
So the idea's good, but it doesn't look nice. Is that right?
The movie looks great.
Oh, really?
I'll watch it this week.
I'm going to watch this one.
I really liked it. It's some real cool fight. Well, it's featuring Chris Evans, a.k.a. Captain America.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And also...
I only remember Chris Evans being in it.
Billy Elliot.
Oh, yeah.
I can't remember his name.
He's still going.
Yeah, oh, yeah. He's smashing it, mate.
That, didn't he?
Yeah, he did Jumpers as well, didn't he?
Yeah, Jumpers, yeah. With Anakin.
Oh, yeah, it was Anakin, wasn't it?
Anakin, wasn't it?
I've older never Anakin. Seen anything else. Was it the older Anakin that got a lot of shit? Was it the younger Anakin?
Old Anakin got a load of crap.
Was it old Anakin?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I remember you telling me about it.
Yeah, old Anakin got a load of shit, but young Anakin's just gone to jail, right, for going fucking nuts.
What?
You know, the little one that was in Jingle All the Way with Arnie.
Really?
Yeah, he's gone
nuts.
Shit,
is that
the
same
bring
kid?
It up. You can look at his mugshot as well. He looks fucking nails. He's got his hair off. And he's like,
oh my god.
And he just still looks a bit like Anakin. He like
he's really gone
took
to the
loads
dark
of
side,
shit and went joyriding down the fucking motorway and like going nuts. Oh, I think he's gone to like a mental
There's a
home
correlation now. Between celebrities are doing that and going mental, isn't there?
I think every celebrity's got to go mental at some point.
Yeah. Depending on how big you are as well. Mel I'm Gibson surprised just Justin Bieber's still keeping it together.
He had his mental thing. He's, yeah. He's
Do you think
back.
He's past it?
Yeah, he's back.
Dude, this is what I love, man. I fucking hate him. They're like, it's so cool to hate Bieber. Fuck you guys, man. If I had $1 billion at like 13, I'd
yeah,
be
you'd be
nuts.
Yeah.
I'd be
worse.
Yeah. I'd be way worse than
oh,
Bieber.
Man, I'd be fucking, I don't know.
Sleeping under hookers.
Yeah, I'd have prozzies on my face, yeah. Left, right, and centre, doing what I want.
Yeah.
I like to
drink
think,
driving.
I like to think Bieber's calmed down now because like Skrillex and Diplo have kind of taken him under
like,
his wing.
Yeah, like
they're like, hey, come on now, lad.
Just yeah, they are, aren't they?
Let's simmer
Before
down.
Before that,
he
was slapping bounces at clubs or something.
Yeah.
Because I heard his dad was a bit of a bad influence.
Was he?
His dad used to just let him do what he wanted.
Yeah, but he's Canadian, so he should just be really nice.
Is Bieber Canadian?
Else. Yeah.
Mind blown.
Oh, Canadian, eh?
Hildu.
Is that your Canadian accent?
Hello there.
Hello there. I'm Canadian.
Hello there.
Oh, Canada.
Oh, Canada.
Oh, dear.
As is tradition.
Yeah, I have got mass respect for him, I think.
I like him. I
don't mind him. I ended 2015 a believer.
A believer, yeah. I watched his movie and I was like, I'm a believer.
I never watched his. Never Say Never.
Is that Never Say Never?
Yeah, I've never actually watched it. I watched like the first 20 minutes when I was hungover.
I saw the One Direction movie.
I was like, this is fucking heavy.
Whoa, man.
It's too many colors, man.
I need to calm down.
Everyone's so fucking happy, man.
Never Say Never. Fuck.
Did you see that thing where he came out the other day and said that he's no longer doing
cocaine.
Fan appearances? You know, like the meet and greets.
Oh, yeah.
He probably can't anymore.
Yeah, he's not doing meet and greets anymore, and he's not doing selfies, and he's not hugging fans anymore, either.
You probably can't when you get to it. Like, he is probably one of the most famous. Who can relate to him as a person? Say you're sat down, like he comes in here to now, and we've talked with him. How can we get on his level? You can't.
Oh, no, you can't. You can have a conversation.
No, but you can have a conversation, but he wouldn't. If he was to explain what it is like to be you, he would be like, it's fucking nuts.
I can't go anywhere.
We're
inviting him into another interviewing situation. If you wanted to get talked to him properly and get on his level, get rid of all this shit.
I think podcasts.
This is another interview situation. He's going to be like, oh, hey, guys, new album's going to. He's going to that persona again.
He's
like,
going to just
like how we
drop
talk
back into
kind
that.
Of, like, you know, on this, like. We talk the same as this.
Slightly different.
We
yeah,
have a better kind of radio communication. You know what I mean?
I like to think this is way more laid back than fucking radio.
Oh, yeah, it is. But you know what I mean? We still have like a conscious of like.
Yeah, you do.
Sure
do you reckon
things-
that will drift away though the more we do this?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
I hope so because that's what I want it to become. I want it to become just this like free flowing of fucking chat
yeah,
and ideas.
So. Ooh, and then maybe we'll become Bieber.
Next stage is Bieber.
Never say never.
We get all prima donna with it.
Coming back to like you saying about Bieber and how you can't understand and you can't relate and all that, but all you got to do is tell him to look at his bank account, see how much money's in there. It's because of these people that want this meet and greet. Just go fucking appreciate it.
Yeah.
Just go. All it takes is for you to say hello to those for a second. And that's their life's made, and that's a second out your day.
I guess so, but you can't do that for everyone. When you're on that
level...
Yeah,
but level, these people... These meet and greets...
Then you become a product yourself, don't you?
But these meet and greets, people were paying for.
Yeah.
Like, it's not like he was being forced into that. That was just like a thing what you do.
What do you think his reasons were for not doing it, though? To
just
keep sane?
Little bitch.
But maybe there's so
no,
long
I think I think you underestimate how hard it actually is. Like, we say, oh, yeah, how hard it is to be a fucking celebrity. He gets loads of money. But it's legit. Like, it must be straining
but
on, like,
Chris,
you.
Cristiano Ronaldo did that video recently of him going out for a coffee. He went down to his local coffee place, sat down. I think in total he did, like, 80 selfies.
See, I wouldn't even like that at this stage.
See, now I kind of get it. You know...
You kind of just want to go out and sit down and just chill.
Just fucking get a photo, absolutely everyone. Imagine how many times you had to pretend to be nice. You can see why they snap. You're like,
and,
oh, hey, nice to meet you.
And
too.
Then they get,
oh,
warped.
You're a fan. Oh, thanks. You just kind of get. Oh,
it would start.
Of the
it would start
that.
Off sincere. It really would, but then it would just get grinding. It really would.
Yeah, on the climb to being famous, you'd be really sincere, and then when you're really famous, you go, oh, I'm still sincere. And I think when you get to like how many people say it to him every day, you're like.
Plus, you've also
I know,
got.
I am really appreciative, but I'm sorry, but I've kind of, you've kind of desensitized me to to feel that happiness again, if you know what I mean.
And plus, you've also got people like coming out the woodwork who used to be your mates years ago, especially if you just got famous or won the lottery, that are being so disingenuous and just like, oh, I haven't seen you for ages, man. But you know what they want. They want to be with you because you're either fucking, you know, they want to be, they want something from you.
Yeah, yeah, I get
it. And you feel like you're being lied to a lot by other people. And you would think, you'll start to really see a warped view of the world.
Mm.
It will get like that.
I'm going to have to ask.
We'd have to ask him. We'll get him on.
Yeah, we'll have to ask him.
Can you
hook that up?
I'll tweet him.
Tweet him, see if you get him on.
At YuckyDuck Team.
Legit, who what kind of celebrity do you think at this point we could...
What do you reckon, what level?
What level can we get? Kerry Katona?
Yeah, I reckon that Kerry Katona level.
Nick Cage.
We could not get Nick Cage.
It's a matter of time until Nick Cage comes out.
Yeah, eventually we'll get Nick Cage, but I can't imagine now. I think we're
It's a matter of time before
we... I think we
could
get Ross Kemp.
That's why Jen...
I think we could get Ross Kemp. He would as well. He's a fucking
that
dude.
That clip of him when those people are trying to abduct him and he's just stood there going, you ain't going to shoot me. You ain't shooting me.
Yeah. No one's going to fucking kill me.
That was it. Yeah,
and he just sips his water.
Yeah. And he just sips his water.
He did sip his water as well. Yeah, it's so right. Yeah.
He did say afterwards that he had no idea what he said because it was all just like an adrenaline blur. He said that was just his body. That's what his body just did naturally.
Fight or flight, mate.
He fully just went for it.
I could fully tell you if I was in that situation, I'd be on my knees sucking all the things guys off.
Mate, I'd have all...
I'd be like, I suck your dick. I'll have all sorts of a cock inside me. I'll be like, I will suck your dick. I will be your slave.
But David, spit roasting in the bush.
We're only asking you for money. I'll just suck your dick.
And honestly, I can give you my dick or I'll take yours.
Anything. Two guys at once.
They're just asking you to sit down, Dave. Sit down.
And I'm grabbing his cock.
I'll kneel down.
I would suck.
I know you're joking. But you probably would
just give me it. Come on my face.
Oh no.
End podcast there.
I know, to be fair, I'd rather it on my face than have to swallow it.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah,
I know.
I'd rather walk around knowing I got jizz on my face than a belly full of cum. Like a Jizz Kiev.
Is that going to be your autobiography, Nathan?
Jizz Kiev.
No, the face full of... No, what was it?
Rather have a face full of cum than a belly full of jizz.
Yeah. The Softie story.
The Softie story.
Just a biography. That's... You're going to write it for me.
That's the thing we should do on the podcast as well. Get your stories on the go. I want some of those in.
What stories?
You know, when you used to do... Well, you did these few tests where you used to write these things on Facebook, these statuses, and they used to be quite good. I used to find random clips. That's things we need to do as well. That'd be funny.
Oh, yeah. I was going to start writing those again.
I don't know what we're talking about.
I'll have to show you some.
You have to just get some plinky plonky music up.
You won't find them now. Not now. I tried to find one the other day. They are miles down. Going for that fucking wall. Yeah.
Well, to be fair, when we did the test of this, this is going back a year and a bit ago now.
Yeah. I think it was last September.
That's when I was reading those out.
It's absolutely ridiculous. How long have we done?
We are currently at 1 hour and 8 minutes.
Wow. Ooh.
So it's around that time, yeah.
Do you wrap it up?
Yeah,
that was good.
That was nice.
It's fucking gone. It's flown by. I thought it was about 50 minutes.
What was your top three films?
My top three films?
Are we going to end it on this? I can't do this, I don't think.
What, because you don't know yours?
I'm trying to think. Go for yours.
In no particular order.
Yeah.
Do you want it in 1, 2, 3?
No. I don't think it should be in order. I hate that. I've got like a top 10 films. I don't like them all the same.
My top three films. It's not because they're great films. It's because what they mean to me... How old I was at the time, blah, 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 blah. Yeah. So, Independence Day, the original one.
Yeah.
Will Smith, dope.
Yeah, Will Smith.
Hello. Space Jam.
Yeah.
The documentary.
That's a good one.
Yeah. It's a documentary. It's a real thing. Michael Jordan's
life. To close that little golf hole got to the Looney Tunes world.
It's real. And Shooter, Mark Wahlberg.
Shooter, that is a very good film. That's
such a strong movie.
Yeah, that is a strong film. In fact, that made me love Mark Wahlberg. That film made me go... Actually, yeah, he's a fucking solid actor.
He's dope.
Yeah, he's good.
I like him. I'm a big fan.
What about your Softie? Can you even?
Mine? Okay, so I think mine would be clearly Star Wars, the trilogy is one. The original.
Yeah, I was going to say this.
Yeah, 4, 5, 6. I'd have to have loads, but if I had to crush those three now that come into my head, it'd be Star Wars. Then it would probably be Hook. You ever seen Hook?
No.
Robin Williams.
No.
He plays an older Peter Pan, and he goes to Neverland again, but he's forgotten to be Peter Pan. You've never seen this film?
No, I don't think so. No.
Oh, man. That is like my childhood film.
Really?
Oh, man. Oh, give me shivers thinking about it. He's like, I think you can fly, Peter. And he's like, and he learns to fly again, and he gets his sword. Oh, man. It's like, oh, you just got to see it, man. It's got that practical magic to it as well.
I'll add it to the download list.
Yeah, Hook, man. It's old. It's pretty old. But, you know, it's got Robin Williams in it. So, you know, it's going to be fucking awesome.
Robin Williams, great actor.
Yeah.
Rip.
And my third one, I'll have to pick a recent one, I suppose. Most recent film that I like. Mad Max is a recent film.
Oh, that's surprising.
Yeah, just for a recent one.
Mine.
The practical effects on that. Oh, fucking well done. Yeah.
What they did real there is unreal.
Wow, that's what film is should always be about.
Yeah, yeah. Totally always. Agree.
CGI is kind of like they did in Star Wars. I like that. They in the new one, they put it where it needed to be.
Yep.
Not full fucking whack.
No. It was fucking. It looked amazing to me.
If you can't physically do it, use the CGI. If you can, it's too expensive. We'll fucking pay for
it. I've got mine.
Okay.
I just thought, yeah, because you thought made me think about like childhood ones that made me think, wow, I've watched over and over again. So Shawshank, because I just love it. It's just a great film. Great, good feeling film, kind of.
Andy Dufresne.
Star Wars trilogy, same as you. I've got to put that in there.
Yeah.
The 5, 6, and 7.
Yeah.
Definitely. No, 5, 6, 7? 4, 5, 6.
Wait, 4, 5, 6. 7.
Sorry, sorry. 5, 6, 7. And for childhood memories, Jurassic Park.
Oh, yeah.
It still holds up.
Yeah, you still can't see. I want to add that in now. There's too many. I can't do it. I can't just have a top three. But childhood film, Hook, man. Check it out.
Childhood film for me, Jurassic Park.
Yeah.
Childhood film for me, Space Jam.
Space Jam. That's a good film.
So fucking
love Space Jam. Well, let's wrap this up. Fucking hell.
Yeah.
Episode 3 done. Thanks for joining us. If you joined us.
Thank you very much.
If you didn't. Softie, you boy.
And this is Dizzle. And behind, can we have some reverb, please? And behind the controls is our main man, Tom Cooley. We'll be back next time with Rob.
Yeah, hopefully. With DJ Swaz.
I'm going to try and get some guests on as well.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Love you, bye.
Love you, bye.
Whoa.